I bought my first GoPro camera, finally. Believe it or not, I've never owned a GoPro camera. Out of all the videos that I've done on YouTube, I've been able to stay away from GoPro up until now. I've had some audio issues with a Canon M50 that I used primarily for shooting most of my videos, and the other day I went out and bought a new GoPro, and that's what this video is going to be about. I put it on the side of the mixer and on the payloader on a couple of different shots there this morning. That's what you're going to see next in this video here. And then towards the end of the video, I put four cameras on the side of the combine to just kind of give you a comparison shot between video and audio quality on a Drift Ghost S, a Drift Ghost XL, a Canon M50, and then of course this GoPro Hero 9. These other three cameras are cameras that I've used throughout the years, if you will, on YouTube, and I think you'll be surprised as to see the quality of this GoPro camera. I know I was quite surprised. I've never owned one of these before. So let's roll into the video, folks. I want to thank you in advance for watching, and we will catch you at the end of the video. Nicely, we are gonna mix up the last two loads of feed here now, and then we're gonna service the combine. We just gotta put fuel on it, blow it off, and get shelling some corn. It's gonna be a beautiful day today. I think it's gonna be around 70 degrees. All right, we are just getting done feeding. I just got out of the 7710 and the red mixer wagon. There's a pretty good breeze blowing. I don't know what the audio is going to sound like, but the little mic protector is on the microphone. It's on this media mod. Nate just texted me a little while ago. This silo is down 7 doors, and we're going to run down and we'll show you how much is in the bunk. We've got about 270 acres left, and we're getting full. When I get time today between bin loads and I can break away for a second or two, I'm going to throw the cameras up on the side of the combine and we'll do a comparison between the video and the audio quality. Between the GoPro and the drift cameras, and I'll also put the Canon camera on the side of the combine as well. Hopefully the audio works on that one while we do our little test here, but I'm pretty well impressed with the GoPro camera so far. We will get into some of the things that I don't like about it, but we better get to the field now and get the combine ready to go and start shelling some corn here. Again, there's a pretty good breeze blowing, and I don't know, usually the wind screws with the microphone and it sounds like crap, but let's get to the combine. So there is the 9410 there, and you can see it is covered in corn dust. We've had a couple of days where we've combined corn and it was drizzling rain a little bit and the dust just sticks to it. So we'll have to give that a nice bath when we get done doing corn, but that's the least of our worries right now anyways. So yeah, okay, so that's how much we have in the bunk, so that's getting pretty well full. Another couple days of running in there, and that's gonna do it for that bunk. And then we're thinking if we have to, we can put high moisture corn in that bunk that's right in front of the 8320 there. We had BMR silage that we chopped last year that we fed out here a little while ago. Okay, so I want to start off by thanking everybody for watching the video. And if you like what you've seen so far, if you could kindly hit the thumbs up. Now, the footage that you have seen so far has all come from a GoPro Hero 9 camera. Now, to get into the sucky part of the video, we're going to tell you what I like and what I don't like about the Hero 9 camera. Right now, I'm filming this with a Canon M50. I've had some audio issues with this Canon camera, and that pressured me to look for another camera because I had lost quite a few opportunities where the audio wasn't there in the video that I videoed. So that's no good. It's just no good when you go to video something and you have no audio there. It kind of ruins the whole thing. Now, I know quite a few people end up, you know, videoing with their cell phones. That's all fine and good. You know, you got the phone right with you. You don't have to carry any extra equipment. But I need the phone to be a phone and a camera to be a camera. Now, this GoPro camera I just got here the other day. And we're going to kind of explain what I like and don't like about it. Prior to the Canon camera, I had used drift cameras. This is what's called a Drift Ghost S. I have had a number of these cameras. I have also had the Drift 4Ks. I've got a Drift XL. I've had the Drift Stealth cameras. They're an okay camera. I still use them now to get, you know, shots on the equipment. You know, I just stick them on there. I've got a magnetic base. I've never bought a GoPro camera before because I always use these. Call me ignorant, call me what you want, but I ended up buying my first GoPro camera here the other day. Now, these drift cameras, the nice thing about these is they have a rotating lens. They're a little sleeker, maybe. This camera here, I can throw it in my sweatshirt pocket and, get the job done. But the problem with these things is, especially this one, and I'll put all four cameras together here. I'll put the Canon, the GoPro, this Drift or Ghost XL, and the Ghost S. I'll put them all on the side of the combine when I get them in it, and we'll compare the footage. The audio is crap on that XL. You have to run a auxiliary mic, and that's just a creates a whole freaking mess. But this GoPro Hero 9, I couldn't be more impressed with this camera. I've got a gooseneck mount with a magnetic base on it. It's got the GoPro quick release buckle on it, which is mounted into the 2 feet that are on the bottom of the GoPro. Now, I ended up getting the media mod kit with this GoPro camera. The media mod kit is essentially a case that goes over the outside of the camera. We're going to talk about that here for a second. We're just going to take this quick release thumb screw off of the mount, because in order for you to, talk about that in a second here. So I'm just going to take the thumb screw off the mount here, and I'm going to, of course, drop that on the floor and lose it. Throw the mount in the bag there, and the mod kit itself has a little door on it. You can pull the camera out, and that's what it is. This mod kit has a USB-C port in the bottom face of it, and that plugs right into the camera itself, and then that enables you to be able to hook an auxiliary microphone up to it, plug in a HDMI cable, or you can plug in a USB-C charge cable to it. Charge the battery on the camera through this mod kit, or run an auxiliary microphone off of it if you want to run like a wireless microphone or whatever. In order to run a microphone, from what I understand, on a GoPro camera, you got to have a fancy adapter cable to plug into the camera in order to use a microphone. Now, this media mod kit has a microphone that's already built into it, right here. This microphone is a forward-facing and a rear-facing microphone with a clip-on windscreen. In that last clip where I was standing in front of the silo, I was videoing with the GoPro 9, and the wind was blowing pretty good, and I was surprised that the audio wasn't distorted at all from the wind. The one thing I do not like about this mod kit, in order to get to the battery, which is in the end of the camera, you have to detach the mount that you have on the camera, because these GoPro cameras have these 2 feet on them, and then that's what mounts into the mount that's on the quick release GoPro deal. And then on this mod kit, it's got a hole in the bottom of it that the feet stick down through. You cannot slide the camera out unless you detach the mount. So that's the one thing I don't like about it. It's an extra job to get the SD card out and to get the battery out. Now, I have not had an instance yet where I've had to get to the battery to swap out batteries between filming this shoot or that shoot or whatever, you can plug a USB-C charge cable right into the mod kit and it'll charge your battery up, or you can plug in an auxiliary battery to it. So that's pretty handy, but to get the stuff off the SD card, you've got to detach your mount. So that's the one and only thing I don't like about the media mod unit itself. This camera was roughly $400. I ended up buying it at Best Buy, and the mod kit was like $79, I think. Now, if you go to GoPro's website, you can get some accessories with the camera for $349. You get an extra battery and a little handheld, like a selfie stick deal and whatever. If I had realized that before I got mine from Best Buy, I would have bought it direct from GoPro. So anybody that's interested in these GoPro cameras, I would suggest go right to GoPro itself and you can get a discount on it. If you go through GoPro. Now, if you choose not to get the Media Mod Kit, I would advise you to get some kind of a cage for the camera itself. I bought this one here on Amazon. It's got two little fixed feet on the bottom so that you can mount the mount into it, and then the camera slides in from the side, a cover goes over it, locks the camera in place, and you can access the battery and the SD card right from this end, and you don't have to take the camera out. So this cage provides enough protection that you're not gonna have to worry about, you know, if you drop the camera or something, and then it's got a two cold shoots on it, just like the mod kit. And if you choose to go this route, you just get an auxiliary microphone, buy their little dongle kit, and use this unit here itself. I'm rather impressed, like I said, with this mod kit. The microphone is built in. It's a little more of a sleeker design. The microphone is a little more, it's a little smaller, makes the unit a little smaller, a little easier to handle, if you will. So we are going to show you some footage from all four cameras. Just kind of give you a comparison of the two drift cameras, the Canon and the GoPro. It's going to be the same clip, about 5-6 seconds long, and it'll give you video quality and audio quality between the four cameras. So here is the footage now, and I'll have a little title under each video as to what camera you are viewing. Let me know what you think the best video was, or best quality camera was, in the comments down below between those four cameras. The first one was a Drift Ghost S, the second one was a Drift XL, third one was the Canon M50, and then of course the fourth one was the GoPro Hero 9. So thanks for watching, folks, and we will catch you at the next one.